Good morning. You're listening to FloorDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Harr. I'm in Chicago at the NAFCD's convention, and I'm with Bob Thompson, who up until 8 years ago was the leader of J.J. Haines. Bob, how you doing?
I'm doing great today. How are you?
Good. I wanted to pull you aside because this morning you won one of the Lifetime Achievement Awards that was given, and I wanted to talk a little bit about your background. Congratulations on that achievement.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Tell our listeners a little bit about your background, if you will. Like I said, up until 8 years ago, and I believe for about a 10-year period, you were the head of J.J. Haines. Most everybody knows that J.J. Haines is the leading distributor in the floor covering business.
Yeah, so originally I started off right out of college. I went to the University of Florida. I started out of college and went to work for Armstrong in 1963. You know, went through the training program and then became a sales rep out in the field. Worked a number of field assignments as assistant manager up in New England. Then I worked on the staff back in Lancaster for a number of years. And then when Armstrong built a new factory in England to supply product throughout Europe and Scandinavia, I went over there as the product manager. And then eventually became general sales manager for Europe. Then I was repatriated back to the United States, and I was working for a subsidiary company of Armstrong that was called Empire Carpet Corporation. No longer around, but they were a floor covering distributor in New England. And I worked for them for a couple of years and went back to school at Babson College to get an MBA in finance, and decided to go actually work for one of Armstrong's customers down in the Baltimore area, which was the Zamoski Company. And they were a large company in the housewares, appliances, electronics, at Zenith and Sony and Gen Air and a lot of the name brands. And I thought it would be an interesting experience to do something other than just floor covering. Even though I liked floor covering, I thought it would be more of a challenge. So I went to work for that organization and eventually became president of it. But over that period of time, as the business climate changed, we began to emphasize flooring more, and the appliance business kind of went away with the big box retailers, the same thing with electronics and housewares too, and we ended up building the flooring business into the largest business, and we were Haines' major competitor. And after a period of time, we were selling our primary products were Armstrong products like Haines, and it became obvious that long-term, having two distributors with two order desks, two delivery fleets, a lot of that, there was a lot of redundant costs. And make a long story short, the Zamoski family ended up selling the flooring business to Haines, and that's how I ended up going with Haines in 1996.
So starting in 96, J.J. Haines, you came in to lead it, and it continued to grow exponentially. What do you attribute that success to?
Well, the main part of it is the culture that we had. It started with how we treated our people, how we valued our people, how we gave our people the opportunity to prosper, to grow, to take responsibility for their actions. We really just fostered that culture. But I think that the big growth and the success of the company really has happened after I left. I really attribute that to the team. The five people that run Haines today, the major responsibility that the board of directors or outside board of directors gave me was to build a team that could lead the company in the future when I decided to retire. And it took me about 4 years to put together a team of five individuals who could work with one another, who were all aggressive in their own way, but who could work together. And as a consequence, since I've left, the company has grown dramatically, even with the downturn. And when I left, we only went down through, I guess, the northern part of South Carolina. And today they go all the way down through Florida. So that team, I think, has been able to really build the business.
As you look back on your past, and maybe you just answered this because you talk about building this team, and most people know, you know, Bruce Wicker is the head man now of the organization. What is, you look back on your career, what are some of the highlights? What are some of your proudest moments?
Well, I'd say that is the most proud moment. Yeah, I talk with my wife often about it, and I've often talked with some of the outside board of directors afterwards. I think that if there's anything you can say about a legacy is what do you leave behind? And being able to put together a team, I mean, they operated while I was there, but I've been gone for 8 years, and they're still together and still growing strong. I mean, that really makes me feel good and proud that you're able to put together something like that where they can stick together, they grow, they feed off one another, and the business thrives as a result of it.
You know, most people in the business have heard of this name, Hoboken, and they didn't do so well. What do you think the difference is between what happened to Hoboken and, of course, how successful J.J. Haines has been?
I think it's the culture and how we looked at developing the people underneath us all the way down through the organization. I mean, they sold the company, you know, and things happened differently. And Haines has always, even though it's a family-owned business, there's over 125 shareholders of Haines. Family plus some key employees have stock in it. And as a consequence, we built the organization for the people, for our customers. We're not interested in just, you know, making a buck and trying to quick sale. We're really looking for the long term. And more importantly, serving the customers, making sure they feel very comfortable with doing business with the company. They can trust us. We do what we say we're going to do, back up any mistakes we make and make them right, and make people feel good about buying from us, and hopefully we provide the kinds of products that make sense for the customers to buy.
At the podium this morning, you said two things I took a note of. One of them is a very fundamental one, is as you say, when people ask you what you did for a living, you say, I sell flooring. And another thing you said was, you know, people stay in this business. It's interesting how this is a industry where people stay in the business. Why do you think that is?
You know, I'm not really sure why that is, but I suspect the basic thing is that in being in this business, people in this business respect one another. I mean, they compete with one another, but they're not cutthroat in the sense that they want to put the other guy out of business. Yeah, you want to win, but people like each other in this business. And as you'll see at the, you know, the meeting today, lots of competitors in the room, but people respect one another. They share ideas. But I think it's the likability factor. And we're dealing with, in many cases, our customers, the mom and pop stores. You're dealing with good, wholesome American people that run businesses on Main Street day in and day out. You know, if they like you and you like them and you provide them with what you want, it's a lot of fun. Even though it's hard work, it's a lot of fun, and you enjoy coming to work every day and going out and meeting your customers, and it's just the atmosphere. And I think that that's true throughout the whole industry. As my career, as I've traveled, you just find that people get in and they love this business, and they, you know, everybody enjoys going to work every day and doing what they're doing.
I'm looking at you talking right now, and I think that the answer is actually on your face. You're smiling, healthy, Bob, and it looks like that you've always had fun in this business. Tell me, you're in great shape. You've been retired for 8 years. I understand you've been doing some work with the United Way, and you stayed active. Congratulations on winning this award. I think you definitely have earned it. You can tell by listening to you. Again, been talking to Bob Thompson, who is a former leader of J.J. Haines and the recipient of the NAFCD's Lifetime Achievement Award, and you've been listening to Kemp Harr and FloorDeli.net.